Yo, what up? Today's video, I will be showing how I got 21 wins in the global tournament. I was 0-0 like 2 hours ago, and I just did a speed run on it and finished at 21 wins. So, yeah, 21-4. I didn't even get to finish the tournament, but we won four of our last games. We were like 15-1 or 15-2, or we might have even been 15-3. We just won a lot, but we'll be going over the last like four replays on how I won. So yeah, let's get into it. So this one, I think this guy actually just gave us a free one, right? Nope, he did not. All right. So this match, we're going to T-Giant. So skip here. We go Zappies in the back. He goes Skeletons. So now we just got to wait. He goes Arch Queen. So we're just going to go Skelly King in the back opposite lane so we don't run into it because it's like kind of annoying. Or no, I think we fireball. Yeah, we fireball. Okay, and then we just wait for the Arch Queen to get close to the tower. We don't leak any Elixir, but we just log. And the deck we're using is very good. Maybe I can get a badge, top 1K with it sometime. I feel like I'm more likely to get top 1K in ladder with E-Giant than top 1K with in GT. I feel like I'm better at one trick in ladder, or E-Giant. But the thing about E-Giant and ladder is you just have to win 50% of your games, so GT, you have to win like 28 games or so. It's pretty hard, but so this guy's using E-Giant, Arch Queen. So right here, I just going for a big push. We know he uses his NATO. So the second he does that, I pop my ability, and I know he's gonna get a counter push. He goes Arch Queen opposite lane, which I think was kind of dumb. It might have been a misclick. I don't really know. My skeletons, the Lariats, were just clutching up. We know he just uses ability, so we're gonna do that. We could log that back, so the Brawler wouldn't get a hit, but we just tank it because I feel like that's a decent, it's fine because we're already down a little bit on Elixir. I didn't want to be down even more, so we just go cycle Fisherman here. We know he's using E-Giant at this point because he has Arch Queen and a cage, so I'm assuming it's E-Giant. So I go Fisherman, and then he ends up going E-Giant Bridge, so I probably should have placed it like a couple tiles higher, but it's all good because I didn't have Zappies in hand, which was kind of unfortunate. So I should have gone Skelly King high for the bomber. And then I end up going Skarmy here. But luckily we got it after the tornado, but it was pretty unlucky timing. But we know he can't really stop our push here. So we just pop our ability. And I think we take out tower here. I don't know. Let's see. Okay, we don't take it out, but we almost take it out. So we go with RG. He's about to go cage. So at this point, I just log the skeletons, log it back, and then we just fireball all that, and then the RG finishes up the tower. And then I go Mother Witch here, hoping he wouldn't just be brain dead and just put E-Giant on the bridge and spam. I mean, if I were him, I would do the same thing. So I realize I messed up, so I'm just going to reset, go Skelly King here, and instead of Fisherman-ing it back, Fisher, using my Fisherman, because the King Tower has like 1,800 more to health than the Princess Tower, the side towers, I decided to just go Zappies. And then right here, I knew in single extra, I don't know if it's my matchup or not. It probably is. He does that bomber for my Zappies, and he has Arch Queen, which can be annoying. So we're going to go Mother Witch here. And we know if we just get those cages out of the way, like, there's really no way he can defend this. So we're going to go Fisherman, take this out. And then we're just going to set up with Zappies. He decides to go E-Giant Bridge, which was pretty dumb. I probably should have logged earlier to take out his Brawler, but it's fine. He went Bomber in the middle, and then we have Zappies alive, so he's not going to break through. So now I'm just going to go RG at the bridge, and I know we have like a big counter push. So we go Fisherman in the pocket to predict his cage, and we get it. So now, and he just uses his NATO. So right as he uses his NATO, we just spam. We went log to the right, sort of, because I thought that's where he was going to put his bomber, try to protect it, but he didn't. So we're going to fireball the bomber. And then we know he literally just has to go in. So we go Zappies in the pocket. And then we go Skelly King high. I could have Fisherman it away, but he could have predicted that, so I didn't want to risk it. So then we just go Skarmy. And then I think we try to pop our ability, and we do. And then right here, we just start spell cycling. We do log, fireball, and then we just set up on defense. Zappies in the pocket. And then we get our Fisherman ready. So we do Zappies just to distract him. Scout Fisherman in case he goes E-Giant Bridge. And then now we just cycle back to our Fireball and we win. So that was game one. Or the first game I'm going to show you guys. And then, so let's watch this one. So this one, let's see. Okay, this one's Splash Yard. So nothing happens yet. I just decided to go RG at the bridge. And he only defends the Baby Dragon and Barbro. He just takes all that damage. So I'm like, okay. Interesting. So he goes Graveyard and Single. So I go Mother Witch and that. Then I go Skelly King High to defend all that. So I know I'm probably going to win this because I got a ton of pigs in. He has Poison instead of Fireball. So I go Zappies. I know it's a little aggressive. He goes Ice Whiz. So I'm like, he's very low on Elixir. So I pop our ability. He's going to pop, use his NATO right here. I don't know why he didn't NATO that. He wouldn't have lost his tower. Interesting. I think I end up just going Fisherman and thinking he would just give up, and then I think he defends, but we'll see. Yeah, we go in, and he tries to, so we go in here, and he goes Tombstone, so we NATO that, or we log that, and then he NATOs it back, so he's still trying, even though his tower's at 700, but I guess there's only, like, 10 minutes left. I was 21-4, then the GT ran out of time, so at, like, 3:55 a.m., for me, but and then he just gives up here, and then he goes Ice Whiz. He tries to defend, so I'm like, all right, bro, what are you doing? So I just use my ability here when I look back at my screen, and then I fireball that, clean it up, and then now we are currently 19-0. So we take on that one. Let's watch this one. So in this match, we are going against, oh, and yeah, this is the guy, he just gave me a free win. So then we're 20-4. So I just took a free win. So I was pretty happy about that, not gonna lie. And then the game that got us, I think this was the most recent game. Or no, it was Lumberloon. Wait. Did I skip this game? I think I skipped this game on accident. So this was the game, my last game, that got me to 21. So I was 20-4. I looked at the time. I had like 2 minutes left, topped in the game, or 3 minutes left. So I'm like, I'm 20-4, you know, just for the video. Let's try to win one more. So yeah, I faced a lot of Lumberloon. Probably like 4 out of my last 10 matches were Lumberloon, or at least 3. Lumberloon freeze. Most of them had Baby Dragon until this one. The E-Dragon's pretty annoying, but unless you have Lightning. But yeah, it is pretty annoying. So we fireball this just to get it out of the way. We should have fireballed the Lumberjack too, but I was just mainly focused on taking out the E-Dragon. And then I think he just NATOs us back, which right as he NATOs it back, yeah, that was a bad NATO. I know he's down a lot of Elixir. I should have waited. Like, I should have just assumed he was going to do that, so I should have waited until I got 10 Elixir and then put Zappies, but I mean, I still got 2 hits. I go split Zappies, never go Zappies same lane. Because in case, like, say you go Zappy same lane, then what if they go Lumberjack at the bridge opposite lane? You always, I mean, for the side you're actually trying to defend, you want to go 2 Zappies and then 1 Zappy on the other side. And also they have, like, Fireball. If they could Fireball the 2, but then that 1 Zappy, the 1 Zappy will always get a hit on the tower unless it's under-leveled. But, like, in a GT it wouldn't. But say, for example, like, in Ladder, their King Tower is level 14 and your Zappy's, like, a level 12 or something. Or level 13. I'm not sure about level 13. I know for 12, for sure, it won't get a hit. But if it's level 14, like the same level, then it will get a hit. It'll get 1. So that's why you always got to split Zappy. And it can just screw up their interactions. So even though he frees, he went for a big push. We're like, all right. He just used all his Elixir. We're going to go in. We're going to take out his tower. That was a good Barbaro by him. But I'm like, I might as well Skarmy now. Take it out right away. I should have, right as I play Skarmy, I'm like, it was, like, within, like, less than half a second, just the bad reaction time. I should have just gone Zappies, could have taken that out. And then right here, he decides to go for Balloon. So I'm like, dude, I'm not going to defend anymore. There's no point. So I just set up a Giant Skeleton in the back left. And I know it's going to be a 2-tower game and probably go into overtime. And I'm at 20-4 right now. So I'm like, I really want to get this win. So I cycle Fisherman, then it's kind of, I didn't want to go in with RG because I feel like if I went in RG in pocket or at the bridge, it would give him a good counter push. So I'm like, let's just spam him on the right a little bit, kind of force him to waste Elixir on the right, and then lead, which will lead to no counter push at all. So then I'm going to go Mother Witch behind the tower, and they'll clean up the Lumberjack there. And then I'm going to set up with some Zappies on the left, and then I think I fireball. Yeah, Zappies and then Fireball that for sure. And then so he goes NATO and then he tries to do a late freeze, I believe, which is kind of a dumb idea because I can just Fireball that. The Mother Witch is still alive. And then here I think I end up going okay. Right here I go RG in the pocket and then I go Skarmy right away when he tried because I knew he was about to go Inferno Dragon, so I go Skarmy so his Inferno Dragon will lock on the skeletons. And then right here we finish off the tower. And that is game. We cycle to a Fireball. Or I don't know why we went Fisherman. I think yeah. I thought we were one card away, but we weren't. And then yeah, we ended at 21 wins. So this is just on my old account, one of my third account. I don't play on this or my second account. I pretty much just play my main. But yeah, that's how to get 20 at least 20 wins. Here's my activity log if you want to see it. So we lost to one E-Giant guy. We lost to one Lumberloon freeze. We lost to that meta deck that is going to get nerfed soon, and then we lost to that. So, but overall, I think we played pretty well. 21-4, can't be mad at that. Hope you guys did enjoy. If you guys did enjoy, make sure to drop a like on the video, and please consider subscribing. It is free, and it does help a lot. And comment in the comment section, what do you guys want to see in the next video? It'll probably just be like a ladder push maybe, but I don't know. Let me know. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys all in the next one. Peace.